up some questions here for Scott.
Yep. Thanks, Scott. I just love your presentation style. It's always fun to hear you give this safety talk with such conviction in the field. But I know it comes from your experiences, and I think your advice will be really appreciated by the folks who participate in this to make sure that we keep a high standard, high quality of experience for people involved. So first question, several folks asked, can you tell them, you know, what type of post pounder do you use mostly? Is there a specific brand? You know, does it require a lot of maintenance, or you know, do you buy it? Do you rent it? Can you just give them your take on the different ones you've seen and the ones you actually use?
Sure. The one we've used most is an Atlas. I don't have the controls.
Sure. Yeah, let me give you the controls, because then you can bring up that slide
and go back. It's the Atlas Copco, I believe. It's a pretty heavy duty post pounder. We do own it. We don't rent it. What else about that?
What's the price?
Price, I believe, is right around $10,000 for the generator and the driver and the hoses. Hopefully you can see my screen again.
Page 272 of the manual.
Okay. Let me go back here. That's the one
Seen anybody rent them, or can they be rented?
I believe they can. I don't know too many people who have. This is what we own up here. Is the Atlas Copco. I know there are at least some people on the workshop in the last couple of days, or maybe still here, who have this skid drill here. It's a little bit cheaper. There's also another brand, and I can't remember the name of this one. This is something that's run by partners of ours up in Idaho. So I've worked with all three of these. They all have done the job in, I'd say, 90%+ of the settings that I've ever worked in. In terms of the maintenance, yes, like anything else, things can go wrong. I would say on the whole, they have been very reliable, and we haven't experienced too many sort of shutdowns or inefficiencies as a result of equipment.
Are you seeing NGOs and local watershed councils and partners stepping up to say, hey, we'll buy one of these for projects in our little area, and kind of lending those out for project implementation?
I've definitely worked with, on the state sort of government side, groups that have been, moving forward and buying their own post pounders and using that as, in some cases, sort of a way to help keep costs down on projects where maybe projects that I'm brought in on to help on implementation, partners that say, hey, we can take care of the equipment needs now because we're trying to build our in-house capacity. And so you don't need to be, bringing your own equipment. We can supply that. So I'd say, short answer is yeah. More people are getting on board, purchasing some of the equipment needs. Because they may not have the ability to hire large workforces. They might still be working with contractors or outside groups for that. But they are building that in-house sort of capital capacity.
Great. Just a couple more questions before we go to break on time. The hydraulic fluid, of course, is environmentally friendly in case you have a spill.
Yep. That is the case.
Yep. Two more questions I wanted to ask. With the woody material, is it preferable to use stuff that can actually root, like live stakes of willows or willow cuttings, or does it really matter the woody material you use for these structures?
Sure, that's a great question. I don't care about preferable necessarily. That is a huge benefit. If you can get stuff that will root and grow, great. If it's there, by all means. I wouldn't probably place a high premium on trying to get it if it was going to be more work. If you've got a ready source of juniper nearby, use it. Better that than traveling far to get willows.
What about invasive species like tamarisk?
Probably don't want them rooting. We have used tamarisk, but we made sure it had dried out for the better part of, I believe it was 3 or 4 seasons, and that there was no possibility that it could resprout. In that case, it was a great opportunity. There had been invasive removal years prior. They had left the piles on the floodplain, and we were able to use those.
Great. All right. Thank you, Scott. I'm going to turn back to you, Joe, to get folks off to their break.